بالكرة كان ما عندنا أكل، لكن أصلا النبي كان عندي أكل كتير، ديال بأكله سديد ما كلام تأكروج، لأنه ما في حاجة بيجا بطال تيه، حاجات كله ترى هو بس.
Regina can finally cultivate her small piece of land in Lidia village, South Sudan. Unfortunately, many South Sudanese are still waiting for their fields to be cleared of landmines and other unexploded ordnance, a legacy of 20 years of civil war between North and South that has torn the country apart. Thousands of people cannot return to their pre-war homes due to landmines which are scattered all over the country. Lidia is just one of the villages in South Sudan where local populations face constant danger from these lethal devices.
Tahunsil bara lakin kalam jan kan magal de kan ma magal ta kurujo taban jani hao kutulana kede asanana bikurujo
some people were going for agriculture to cultivate. This thing explode.
Ala kandor ke jere musu kalam ta jan. Tama ke de roina ta berwa. Kalam jan ka rubuna silita rubuna ya sil. Ai kan ma kan rubuna ma ter silita ta pekin. Ba de boko kama ta reja fogo. Na kal ta kuna le ta kun yela gito na ina fogo. Adana ke doru ina le haji. Ina pa.
Sudan Integrated Mine Action Service, or SIMAS, an indigenous South Sudanese mine action NGO, started removing landmines in Lidia village in September 2009. SIMAS is the only national demining NGO with technical, material, and human capacities to remove landmines in South Sudan. So far, SIMAS has cleared more than 37,000 square meters, found and destroyed 58 landmines and more than 400 various pieces of unexploded ordnance in Lidia.
Zero. Firing now.
Ana mortasa e mahalle anna pika gikuru jifogo. Tabalkira kan mafinas gikuru jine. Pa ana mortama sema zasanu mwenjamo lo shokolene sebeta kumbaino dora ketir. De asap sokol tasima zalumo ni stakal fi mahali. Wa ana murta seti.
This is one of the main reasons why a small group of South Sudanese enthusiasts established SIMAS in 1999.
And we managed to clear the areas which were not accessible, whether by foot or by roads. And the same time also after the CPA and before the CPA, we managed to clear so many areas in Nuba Mountains and Eastern Equatoria and Western Equatoria, which it is a very good credit to us. We deliver the services to our population and especially to those IDPs, because most of the areas with the IDPs left from it, the indigenous areas with there, we managed to come and clear it, especially in around Juba, in Rajab, some in Liria, and some in Rokon, which it is really a very big credit to the SIMAS that he has managed to clear those areas and he has handed them over to population so that they can start planting whatever type of crops they wanted. And at the same time also not to harm the civilians which are coming back to their areas.
If you started a national NGO with nothing, with only three detectors, with only few deminers who were not accredited by then. All deminers we had in Rumbek in 1999 were former ex-combat engineers from SFLA.
In 2006, SIMAS and the Swiss Foundation for Mine Action, or FSD, entered into a capacity-building partnership with the ultimate aim to develop SIMAS into an independent national mine action NGO operating to international standards. As a result of this cooperation, SIMAS has evolved into the only national mine action organization in South Sudan with technical accreditation from the UN to conduct landmine clearance.
We did very well in 2005-06 with our partners, which is FSD, Swiss Foundations. We managed to train a good number of the manpower, which we have now. And we don't have a doubt about the partnership which we have with FSD and CIMAS. We have did very well, and we are still existing until today. And I believe our partnership was one of the best cooperations with international NGOs. And that's why until today we managed to have a good number of the manpower, and at the same time we managed to get accreditation from the UN for the national NGOs, but through FSD. Otherwise we would have not made it. The things were difficult, but we managed to do it through partnership.
The first step for FSD was to conduct technical trainings for deminers and field operators. Then the focus was given to managerial aspects, strategic planning, networking, and financial management. Today, CIMAS has qualified personnel not only in technical aspects of the work, but in logistics, finance, administration, and general management. Since the beginning of the project, more than 300 national staff have been trained. Most of them had no previous knowledge about humanitarian demining and international standards.
I was a farmer before, so I joined this demining group since 2006-07. So up to now, I was working with the CIMAS as a senior staff of CIMAS.
FSD has organized so far a numerous number of trainings for local staff. We have been always trying to provide the most experienced international experts who will be able to deliver trainings to the highest international standards in mine action.
Proud because before I didn't know anything technically, but as I started with demining as a deminer, went forward with some level in technical side like field technical advisors, EOD course level 2-3, and again how to manage as a line manager the field and supervise and advise on technical issues. I'm very proud of this, because here now we are doing all this minus somebody's contribution. It has, with my contribution, with the knowledge I have, the experience I have, made us to be doing this alone.
CIMAS is probably the only organization who has national team leaders being accredited to lead and supervise operations in the field independently.
I started to be with these people since last year, 2009, up to date. It's me organizing, plan for the task operation, looking after the people, advising on technical thing, deal with an item which is found to be one of the ordnance. So I have been doing it with my people, minus international.
Despite highly trained personnel and strict adherence to procedures, demining work is very risky, and an accident can occur at any time. CIMAS teams are adequately equipped with field ambulances and highly trained medical personnel to assist the teams during their field engagements in case of any incident or accident.
Generally, yeah, as we are here, we are expectant of an accident any time we are ever ready. That's why you see ambulance parked ready, doors opened, showing that any time a casualty, any incident happens in the field, we are ready to transfer to the hospital.
As the only national demining organization in South Sudan with technical and human resources to conduct removal of landmines and unexploded ordnance, CIMAS has been recognized as the backbone of the South Sudan government for the future of mine action in the country.
Let me say it very proudly that when we'll be left without anybody to support our mine action program, and CIMAS is the NGO which we think it will be the backbone of mine action program in the country.
South Sudan Mine Action Authority signed a Memorandum of Understanding on 31 March 2011 with CIMAS, recognizing this organization as its main implementing partner for the future of mine action activities in the country.
I'm happy because I'm clearing landmines, because of, I don't want my children to be in problem of mines or UXO. So I'm really happy.
And we get 50 mines around this area here. But still, we are going ahead. Maybe there's some other things that are still down there, like UXO and mine, they are still down there. That's why we are here.
Our colleagues are working for themselves. They are working for their family, for their nation. They are working to clear land and to use that land for food production and not to have a problem how to survive later on. Probably that is the biggest reason why they are so motivated, and why they are probably, as a national organization, even more motivated than some international organization came here also to help solving out this problem. We are here talking about national organization, national staff who is doing it for themselves and their country.
The CIMAS Explosive Ordnance Disposal Team started collection and demolition of unexploded ordnance in November 2010 in the area of Cor William, nearby Juba. An old ammunition storage dump exploded in 2005, killing six people and scattering hundreds of unexploded artillery shells in a radius of 3 kilometers.
As you can see, all ammunition is scattered around. This area is 500 by 500, so we need to clear all the place. And also, for our safety also, is the first priority for everyone who is operating here.
The CIMAS operators were warmly welcomed by the local population.
We CIMAS, we were having MRE, because MRE is mine risk awareness. To walk around all the villages where local people are, to train them, if you find an object, don't touch. It's risky for yourself. We were supposed to have such people to go around to let these people also know, because some of the people, they came in different locations, might be from the village, they don't know what is UXO, what can kill, they don't actually.
Daiman kan tum gala bukura ala butaun kura fi malali ne deep jede lakin kan malali gaba gaba jede kilizol mara ala bufogo taban fi lagam alagam inak fi danadali kan sibu bekun majes fi inak kanzol dusu kanzol ala bumo fali be fejir kan fejir suru be asir later
mutu
sol be mutu sa
na
fi zol ala leader mutu
lala
ma.
CIMAS CMAS aims to make South Sudan free from landmines and unexploded ordnance, a mission that cannot be achieved without support from the donor community, both international and national.
I'm appealing to the government of South Sudan now to come up, to come for his support to the CMAS. And I'm sure also it's not CMAS alone, which is only indigenous NGOs in landmine. I'm appealing to the authority that to come up also with their own policies, how to fund those national NGOs. Because CMAS has started from zero through the donors, and the donors managed to give us a fund which we are standing today with it. And that's why the CMAS become existing. Especially I give thanks to UNICEF and TROCARE and USAID, and lastly also to our partner, which that is the time all the donors, they don't want to support the national NGOs. But FSD came in and he gave us a full capacity buildings. And that's why CMAS today, we are operating in all the field by the leadership of the local staff. They are the one in the field, they are the one doing instruction, whether in clearance or in MRE. They are the one doing it individually. There is no any international expatriates there with them. So that's my appeal to the government now to come up with this policy and also how to get the fund so that we can achieve the clearance of landmine within 10 years or 12 years. Depend on whatever they can give us and also identify the areas which we can try to do to clear those landmines.
That is this viable NGO which we are very much relying on it. Because the other NGOs, we may be having 6 or 7 or 8 or whatever number, but none of them is working in mine clearance as CMAS is doing. So CMAS, and even there is a paper I have here. We are talking of giving little support to the national NGOs. And it is already in the Ministry of Finance.
CMAS, through its partnership with FSD, has come a long way and evolved into a strong national organization capable of coping with the residual threat of landmines and unexploded ordnance in South Sudan. With strong support from the government of South Sudan and the donor community, CMAS will continue its mission to make South Sudan a safer place to live.
According to our strategic plans, which is going to come out soon, the strategic plan for the landmine clearing in southern Sudan, it might take us not less than 20 years. And that is depend on the funds which we are getting. But if there's enough funds, we can have a plan of 12 years so that to make sure that southern Sudan is free of the landmines and UXO. That is our plan. That is the vision of CMAS. Make sure that there's no more victims of the landmine and UXO in South Sudan.